We're on our way to Casas Grandes in Chihuahua, Mexico. We're on our way to an excavation. One of my big questions is to try to figure out what are the roots of Paquimé, or what we also call Casas Grandes. What makes it unique is its cultural influences from other places. They were breeding scarlet macaws. There are shells that were imported over 250 miles from the coast. We also find architecture that's similar to that of the ancestral Puebloans. Every shovel full of dirt that we pull out is providing new data and information on the ancient people who thrived in the desert.
We dug a trench, and that trench revealed a floor, and we kept expanding that floor, and it kept growing and growing and growing until we had a 9-meter diameter house, which is the biggest Viejo period communal structure known.
Lots of what we can learn about a site comes from the contexts of the artifacts or their relationships to each other in space. And so technology is really helpful in doing that. For example, we have a total station that allows us to map in with millimeter precision everything on the site.
We use drones on many of the archaeological sites we work on. So we'll take multiple images across the entire site and stitch them together into one, kind of what we call an orthomosaic, so a mosaic of all those photographs.
When we're excavating, you know, you're not getting perfectly preserved structures. So I've enlisted the help of an artist, and she's been helping to create an interpretation of the floors that we find, or the little partial walls that we find.
Archaeological illustration doesn't seem to be that big of a field, and so it's really cool to feel like almost on like the forefront of something new.
This is the first project where I've invited a large group of students from the National School of Anthropology and History of Northern Mexico. So their professor, Dr. Nora Rodriguez, will be here. And not only will they be working with our students from BYU, but they'll be working with a professor to learn how to excavate. This is their first excavation.
It's important that the people from different countries not just work together, but become friends. It's pretty, pretty important for the research.
Many of these students haven't been to Mexico, some haven't been out of the country. So they get immersed in not only the language, but the food and the culture.
There's different types of pottery that has like fingernail indentations in it. And I think that's cool because you can tie that specific thing to a specific person.
We always are really respectful of the people and the past because they're with us. Having that spiritual connection to archaeology, it changes everything for me.
We are learning about people in the past, how they lived their lives, how they dealt with human problems. Archaeology can shed light on so many things.
You really have a lot of respect for the people when you see very closely what they did.
I think it's in understanding the past that we can better understand our current position, so that we can make better decisions moving into the future.
I don't think there's anything better than to see that light go off when they pick up that artifact and go, this is what I want to do, this is what I want to keep doing. And then to help them realize the connections that we can make with the past and how that can, you know, better our lives today.